Italian football lover channel, my friends. Atalanta won 1-0 against Juventus. Malinovskyi scored the goal of Atalanta. I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. Let's start with the all tactics of this game. And in this game, on the midfield, every time Freuler moved higher and pressed on Adrian Rabiot. And at the same time, on the midfield, Pessina played 1-1 versus Bentancur, and on the forward, these two forwards, Muriel and Duan Zapata, made press on central defenders. This player, Zapata, pressed on Chiellini, and Muriel played 1-1 against De Ligt on the forward. And every time Gosens higher up the pitch, and he made pressure on Cuadrado, and this player, Meyle, participated to Atalanta attacks from the right wing, and he made pressure on Sandro. And on the forward in Juventus, Morata played close to Palomino, and Dybala played 1-1 versus defender Jim City. But on the midfield, this Derun covered off Dybala in Juventus attacks, and he played close to Dybala, Derun. At the same time, sometimes when Atalanta made higher press on the forward to Juventus, these defenders, Chiellini and De Ligt, came to left and right wider, and Rabiot dropped deep between of Chiellini and De Ligt. They tried to break the higher press of Atalanta, and at the same time, in this game, Cuadrado every time supported the attacks from the right for Juventus. And really, in the first half, this McKinney every time tucked inside, and McKinney sometimes came to left wings. He tucked inside and got into the Atalanta box, McKinney, and Cuadrado moved higher and wider. He centered balls into the Atalanta box, and McKinney searched for the goal positions in Atalanta box, and Federico Chiesa moved higher, and he tucked inside and got into the Atalanta box. He came to back post Chiesa and searched for the goal positions every time, and Chiesa made press on this defender Toloi on the forward. But in the first half, really it was a balanced game, but Atalanta developed Atalanta forced left wing back of Juventus more in the first half with Meyle, and this Pessina came close to right, and at the same time Meyle and Toloi supported the attacks from the right. They forced the left wing back of Juventus, and in the first half Pessina found one goal position between of Sandra and Chiellini. Pessina got into the penalty area, but his shot got out of the pitch, and the first half has been finished 0-0. Really, Atalanta started the second half with a substitution on the midfield. Pessina out, and Pasalic replaced of Pessina, 88 number Pasalic. He played instead of Pessina in the second half. Sometimes Toloi moved higher, and this player Freuler dropped off the cover of Toloi. He came back to right, and really, in Juventus, in the second half, every time, sometimes Sandro tuck inside, and he came to pivot position, Sandro. And really, Juventus defense line turned into three in Juventus attacks, and Cuadrado came to forward, Chiellini, De Ligt, and Sandro together came close to midfield together in Juventus attacks. And every time in the second half, this Andrea Pirlo made some substitutions for Juventus, and Chiesa was little bit injured in the second half, and Chiesa out in this game. And really, Danilo replaced of Chiesa. After this substitution, McKinney started to play on the left of the midfield. McKinney played here, and really, Cuadrado played on the right of the midfield. Pirlo pulled Cuadrado to the right here, Cuadrado, and Danilo played as a right back. And after second substitution for Atalanta in the second half, Really, this player Muriel out and Ricic replaced of him. After this substitution, Gasperini pulled Zapata to the left forward here, 91 number Zapata. And this player Malinovski played Ilicic played close to right after he got into the pitch. Other substitution, last substitution for Atalanta, it was crucial substitution for Atalanta, and Meyla out and Malinovski replaced of him. After these substitutions, Malinovski played close to forward here, 18 number Malinovski. Sometimes Malinovski came close to right, sometimes he came close to left, and he rotated his position with Duan Zapata. And after Malinovski got into the pitch, his one shot out of the penalty area was saved by goalkeeper Chesney. And at the same time, other substitutions for Juventus in this game, last substitution for Juventus, McKinney out and Arthur replaced of him. After this substitution, Adrian Rabiot played on the left of the midfield here, and Arthur played on the center of the midfield here with Rodrigo Bentancur. In Juventus, Danilo and Sandro, they together tuck inside, and they pushed higher together, and he played in pivot position together, Sandro and Danilo. In Juventus, it was so important tactical changing for Juventus in this game. But 87 minutes of the game, Malinovski's shot out of the penalty area, his second attempts of Malinovski, the ball touched Sandro and scored the goal for Atalanta. And it was the goal of Atalanta. Malinovski scored the goal, and Atalanta was 1-0 ahead to the end of the game. And really, in this game, it was so balanced game, and these teams deserved a draw in this game, but Atalanta found the goal with Malinovski and won this game. It was so important and crucial 3 points for Atalanta. In this game, all my analyses and all my comments like this. What do you think about this game tactically? You can write your suggestions and comments under my video. Please open up your notification rings, notification bells. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Thank you very much. See you on my next videos, beautiful people. Bye!